Om Agyanat Marandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Namam Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Sarasati Deve Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacya Deshatarine Jaye Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Baye Vacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasati Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. We are going through Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto. And we have reached chapter number 25, which is about the glories of Lord Ananta. So Sukadeva Goswami had been describing about different planets, First of all, we heard about the earth planet and Bhumandala, and then we went to the lower planets, we heard about the subterranean heavenly planets. And now we're going to hear about Lord Ananta, who resides in the bottom of the universe. So Lord Ananta Shesha is also known as Lord Sankarshan. So he is known by different names. Sometimes he's called Ananta Shesha, sometimes he's called Lord Sankarshan, and he's an expansion of Lord Vishnu. So he lives below Patala Loka. Patala Loka is one of the lower planets in the universe, and Lord Ananta Shesha lives below that planet, Patala Loka. And Lord Ananta is always transcendentally situated, and he is worshipped by Lord Shiva. So because Lord Shiva is a deity of the mode of ignorance, and so sometimes Sankarshan is called Tamasi. Tamasi, Tamas, from Tamas meaning ignorance. So Lord Ananta is the false ego for all the conditioned souls. All of us who are conditioned souls, we have a lot of false ego, and that false ego is coming from Lord Ananta. He is the deity of false ego, and he's also the deity of the material mode of ignorance. He's also the deity for the mode of ignorance. Because in conditioned life, we are thinking, I am the enjoyer, and this world is for me to enjoy.
总是想着我是这个享受者，我是这个世界也意味着被我所享受。
So this kind of thinking, this is coming from, this is being given to us by Lord Sankarshan.
这种概念也是主 Sankarshan 指示给他的。
And when we think like that, we're thinking that we're the Supreme Lord.
我们就是这样想着，我们是至尊主。
So in the Vedic mantras, we say Aham Brahmasmi, meaning I am Brahman. So people think that means that they're God, but it doesn't mean we're God.
在伟达的这个曼陀罗里面有一个 Aham Brahmasmi, 这个是说我是凡，但是呢，人一旦念这个曼陀罗，他就会认为他就是神，但事实上我们不是神。
We are just a tiny part of the Supreme Brahman.
我们只是这个至尊凡的一个很微小的部分而已。
So when we think we are the supreme enjoyer, this is our big illusion.
当我们认为我们是一个至尊的享受者的时候，这是一个非常大的愚昧。
And Lord Sankarshan, he is the deity of this conception.
主 Sankarshan 是这种错误概念的主宰神。
Right, just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, he's in the heart of everyone, and from him comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness.
主 Krishna 在博迦梵歌中也说，我处在每个人的心中，记忆、知识和遗忘都由我而来。
So the Lord is in everyone's heart as Sankarshan.
主以 Sankarshan 的形象处在每一个人的心中。
And when somebody is a demon, they think themselves to be one with the Supreme.
一个恶魔，他认为他和至尊是合一的。
So the demon, Krishna will keep him in that ignorance.
主 Krishna 会让这个恶魔保持在这种愚昧的状态之中。
But the person is so, we're so ignorant, we forget our actual position.
因为由于我们的愚昧，所以我们忘记了我们真实的地位。
And that forgetfulness that is created by Lord Sankarshan.
这种遗忘我们自己真实地位的这种遗忘，也是由主 Sankarshan 所创造的。
But Lord Sankarshan is always transcendental. His body is transcendental. He's not material.
主 Sankarshan 他的躯体也好，他总是超然的，他不是物质的。
And Lord Sankarshan is, he's the worshipable Lord. He is the super soul of Lord Shiva.
主 Sankarshan 也是一个被崇拜的主，他是主 Shiva 的超灵。
And sometimes he will perform, sometimes Lord Shiva will perform these activities in the mode of ignorance.
有些时候主 Shiva 他也会从事一些愚昧形态的活动。
So, for that reason, Lord Sankarshan sometimes is called Tamasi, meaning ignorance.
而造成这一个的原因，主 Sankarshan 有时就被称为 Tamasi.
So the whole universe is like one mustard seed on the head of Lord Anantadev.
整个宇宙就像一个芥末籽一样，在主 Anantadeva 的头顶上。
Lord Anantadeva is in the form of a big serpent, right? Celestial serpent in the bottom of the universe, and he has many hoods, thousands of hoods.
Ananda 身上的形象是千百万个这个蛇棚蛇的这个形象，它有千百万个头。
And the universe is like one, it's like one little white mustard seed.
而这一个宇宙只相当于一个白色的芥末籽那么大。
We're growing mustard just now here in Mayapur. We have a lot of mustard planted just around where we live in Mayapur. So you can see the mustard seeds growing. They're very small.
我们在马雅普居住的这个地方的周围，现在正是收割这个芥末籽的时候，我们可以看到那个芥末籽非常非常的小。
So these, This universe is like one mustard seed when it's on the head of Ananda.
而我们整个宇宙就像一个白色的芥末籽一样，在这个主阿难达身上的头舌头上。
So at a certain time, Lord Ananta Dev has to destroy the entire material world.
在一个特定的时间，主阿难达他需要毁灭整个创造的时候。
So in order to destroy the whole material world, he becomes a little bit angry.
为了毁灭整个物质创造宇宙，他就会变得愤怒。
And then from between his two eyebrows, there appears a three-eyed person called Rudra.
在他愤怒的时候，两个双眉之间显示出一个三只眼的 Rudra。
And this Rudra, he's carrying his trident.
这个 Rudra 拿着他的三叉戟。
So this Rudra, he is also known as Sankarshan.
这个 Rudra 他也被称为 Sankarshan.
And there are 11 Rudras. There are 11 incarnations of Lord Shiva.
总共有十一位主 Shiva 的化身。
And he appears in order to destroy the whole material world.
它显现是为了毁灭整个创造，整个物质宇宙。
Right, the purpose of the material world is to give all of us conditioned souls a chance to get out of the material world.
在这个物质世界，生物只是被给予一次机会，让我们离开这个世界。
But when we don't go back to Godhead, when we just try to enjoy the material world, then Lord Sankarshan gets angry with us.
但是我们生物如果不利用这次机会，不想回归家园的话，主山卡山就会生气。
And because of his anger, the 11 Rudras, all expansions of Lord Shiva, they come out from the eyebrow.
当他一生气的时候，主 Shiva 的扩展十一位 Rudra 全部都从山卡山的双眉之间出来。
And these 11 Rudras, they destroy the whole material world.
这十一位 Rudra 他们将会毁灭整个宇宙，毁灭整个创造。
So Lord Ananta, he has very beautiful pink toenails.
主阿兰达他有非常他有一双透明粉红透明的脚趾。
Right, he has lotus feet, and on his lotus feet there are these beautiful toenails.Which are just like gems.
它有非常美丽的莲花足，而它的这个脚趾头也非常的漂亮，就像宝石一样。
Yeah, and these gems are shining. They're like a mirror.
这个宝石而且还在发光，非常像一面镜子一样。
So when the pure devotees.But the pure devotees and the leaders of the snakes all offer their obeisance to Lord Sankarshan with great devotion.
因此，当这些伟大、纯洁无瑕的大伟大的奉献者和这些蛇王们以极大的奉爱顶拜主山卡尔山的时候
，and they become very happy when they see their own reflections in the toenails of Lord Sankarshan.
他们就非常高兴地见到。因为他们一顶拜，他们就通过主莲花足的这个反射，就看到他们自己，他们非常高兴的看到自己的面庞。
So Lord Ananta Shesha, his arms are very long and attractive, and very nicely decorated with bangles.
主阿兰达的两臂也非常的美丽，也非常的长。而且装饰的非常赏心悦目。
And they're white color, and they look like big silver columns.
这个它的臂膀是白色的，看上去像闪闪发光的耳环一样。
And when the beautiful princesses of the snake kings, right? There's all these snakes there, and they have wives and daughters.Beautiful princesses, they all hope for the Lord's blessings, to get the blessings from the Lord Ananta.
他们的脸庞装饰着闪闪发亮的耳环，他们的美丽的容颜看上去也非常的赏心悦目。
So they make sandalwood pulp, and they have this kumkum powder, and they put it on his arms and touch his different limbs, and in this way they become lusty.
前面有一个翻译掉了，就是当他们希求主的赐福，这些美丽的蛇王的宫主们用空孔，就是那个红色的那个空孔乳浆、檀香浆和库玛尔浆涂抹他的臂膀时，这些蛇王的公主们就变得开始充满了一些色欲。
So Lord Ananta understands that these princesses have become lusty, and he looks at them with a merciful smile.
主阿南达也能从他们的这个感觉里面了解到他们充满了色欲，于是主阿南达就微笑着看着他们。
And when these ladies, these young women understand that the Lord knows what they're thinking, then they blush, they become red, they are a little embarrassed.
当这些年轻的女士感觉到主阿南达他已经理解到他的心思的时候，这些年轻的公主们她们也感到很羞涩，脸就红了起来。
But then they have beautiful smiles.And they look on the face of Lord Ananta, which is also very beautiful. Lord Ananta is a little bit intoxicated, but he's very happy with the love of his devotees.
Lord Ananta is a little bit intoxicated.但是他也非常享受他也非常喜爱他的这些奉献者。
So Prabhupada explains to us, he said, when the male and the female touch each other's bodies, then it will awaken lust naturally in their mind.
圣帕帕德于是就在这里解释到，当男性和女性彼此接触双方的身体的时候，他们的色欲很自然而然就被唤醒了。
So Prabhupada says that we can understand that even in spiritual bodies, even when you have a spiritual body like Lord Ananta Shesha, and that still there are these sensations of lusty desires.
而且即便他们处在这种灵性的躯体之中，这一切原有的这些感觉都存于这个躯体之中，就是这种色欲的原始的感觉都存于这种灵性的躯体之中。
Yeah, Lord Ananta and these women, young women, who were giving him pleasure, they all had spiritual bodies, but they also got lusty.
主阿南达以及喜欢主阿南达的这些蛇的这些公主们，她们都是拥有的灵性的躯体，但是她们那一刻都是充满了一点色欲。
So these feelings like lust, it all originally comes from the spiritual body, all originally exists in the spiritual world.
这种色欲其实都存于原始的灵性躯体之中，它们都来自于灵性世界，这个色欲是来自于灵性世界。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it begins Janmadyasya Yata, thatThe origin of everything is from Krishna, that Krishna is the cause of creation, maintenance, and destruction.
在圣典博迦瓦坛里面讲到，一切都源于至尊主，一切都源于 Krishna. Krishna 是一切的源头。
So Janma Adi Asya, the Adi, the Acharyas say this is Adi Ras, the original feeling, lusty feeling.It's the original feeling, and it comes from the Supreme Lord. But we should not think that lust is like our lust in the material world. That lust is spiritual lust.
就是灵性的色欲跟我们物质的色欲是一样的。
Yeah, just like gold and iron. Spiritual lust is like gold and material lust is like iron. There's a big difference.
就像金子和铁是不一样的, 灵性的色欲像金子一样, 铁, 物质的这种色欲像铁一样, 它们是决然不同的。
So, unless one is very, very elevated in spiritual knowledge, spiritual realization, he won't be able to understand the lusty feelings between Radha and Krishna.
除非一个人处在非常非常高度灵性觉悟的层面, 否则他无法理解Krishna和Radha之间的爱的这种交流,
and Krishna and, Krishna and the gopis of Vrindavan, their pastimes are not material. It's fully spiritual and it's very pure.
Krishna和Vrindavan的这些牧牛姑娘们之间的爱情也是非常纯洁的,
but people don't understand it properly.
但是人们并没有恰当地去理解它。
You have to be advanced in spiritual realization. So we're not allowed to discuss the lusty feelings between Krishna and the gopis, because it's only for very advanced devotees.
因此我们被禁止讨论Krishna和牧牛姑娘们之间的爱欲情感, 因为这是为那些很高级、很精进的奉献者而准备的。
But if we are sincere and if we are pure, then the material lust will be removed when we talk about the pastimes of Krishna and the gopis.
然而，如果一个人非常的真诚而且纯洁的话， 当他们讨论gopi和牧牛姑娘和Krishna之间的爱欲情感时， 他们的物质色欲会完全的消失。
Yeah, we can make quick advancement in spiritual life by hearing about the pastimes of Krishna and the gopis.
我们可以通过聆听Krishna和gopi姑娘们之间的这种逍遥时光，可以在灵性上获得进步。
But we have to be sincere and we have to be pure in our actions and thoughts.
但是我们的动机和我们的行为必须是非常真诚而且纯洁的纯粹的。
We should not misunderstand the pastimes to be material.
我们不应该去理解 Krishna 的这些逍遥时光是物质的。
And nobody should think they can imitate.
而且没有人应该觉得自己可以去模仿这样的逍遥时光。
So Lord Sankarshan is an ocean of unlimited spiritual qualities. He is not different from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And for the welfare of all the living entities in the material world, he lives in his abode.
为了这个物质世界众生的福祉和利益，他居住在他的居所。
His abode, which is at the bottom of the universe, and he's very careful to control his anger and his intolerance.
他的居所在这个宇宙的底部，他控制着自己的愤怒和不容忍。
He's also known as Ananta Dev.
他也被称为是Ananta Dev.
So his main mission is to dissolve the material creation. When the time comes for destroying, it's his job to destroy the material world. But he always will control his anger. He won't release his anger until the proper time.
除非是特定的时间到来的，否则他一直控制着他的愤怒。Material
world is created to give the conditioned souls a chance to go back to Godhead.
物质世界是给予我们这些受条件限制的灵魂一次机会去重返家园，回归守神。But
most living entities don't want to take advantage. They don't want to go.
但是大部分受条件限制的灵魂，他们不想利用这个机会，不想走。
As soon as the creation takes place, they start again. They want to lord over the material world. They want to enjoy sense gratification.
当这个创造完成之后, 我们这些生物他们就又开始想要享受这个世界的癖好又出现了。
So when they do that, then this makes Lord Anantadeva angry.
他们一旦想享受这样做的时候, 主 Anantadeva 就被激怒了。
And he wants to destroy the whole material world.
然后他想毁灭整个物质世界。
But because he's the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he controls his anger.
因为他是至尊人格守神, 所以他能控制他的愤怒。
And he becomes kind towards all the living entities.
而且他变得非常的容忍, 非常的仁慈对于所有受条件限制的生物。
And he waits for the special time when he's supposed to destroy the whole material world.
他在等一个特定的时间，要来毁灭这个物质世界，他在等那个特定的时间到来才行。So
many different people all offer prayers to Lord Anantadeva.
很多人物他们都向主 Anantadeva 供奉祷文。The
demigods and the demons, they both offer prayers to Lord Anantadeva.
无论是半世人还是恶魔，他们都向主阿南达德供奉祷文。
And there are demigods who also have snake bodies. They also worship Lord Anantadeva.
那些半世人，他们也有着蛇的躯体的半世人，他们也向主阿南达德供奉祷文。
And then the Gandharvas who are able to sing and dance, they offer prayers. And the Siddhas, those who have yoga powers, they all offer prayers.
那些悉达拥有玄秘瑜伽力量的瑜伽师们，他们供奉祷文；那些能够跳舞、能够唱歌、唱得很好的甘达尔歌仙们，他们也在供奉祷文。So
Lord Anantadeva, he pleases his personal associates. He has some associates, and he will take care of them. He'll keep them happy.
主阿兰德戴维有一些同游，主阿兰德戴维总是让他的这些同游感到快乐，而且主也很好的照顾他们。His
personal associates are like heads of the demigods. They're in charge of the demigods.
他的主要的同游们有掌管着半世人的首领。
And Lord Anantadeva will please them by sweet words, sweet vibrations coming from his mouth. So Lord Anantadeva, he's dressed in bluish garments and he has one earring, he just wears one earring.
主阿兰德戴夫身穿的是蓝色的衣服，他只戴了一只耳环。And
he has a plow on his back.
而且他有一把犁在他的背后扛着。And
his body is as white as Indra's body.
他的身体跟Indra的身体一样是白色的。And
he has a golden belt around his waist. And a garland of ever fresh tulsi around his neck. So that the tulsi has a very sweet honey like fragrance and it attracts all the bees, and the bees hum around that garland.
这个图拉西的花环它的味道 甚至跟花蜜一样，而且吸引了很多的蜜蜂围绕着它。And
this makes everything it more and more beautiful.
这一切显得越来越美丽。And
this is how Lord Anantadeva, Lord Sankarshan, enjoys his pastimes.
这就是主 Sankarshan, 主 Anantadeva, 他在享受他的逍遥时光。
If somebody is very serious to get liberated from the material world, they have to hear about Lord Ananta Dev from the mouth of a spiritual teacher.
如果一个人真心想要从物质生活中得到解脱出来, 他得从您一位您心导师那里去聆听主Anandadeva的荣耀。
And they should meditate upon Lord Ananta Dev or Lord Sankarshan, who's in their heart.
而且他应该冥想主Anandadeva或主Sankarshan那个住在他们心中的那位主。
And he can vanish all the dirt, all the contamination in the heart from the material nature.
他能摧毁物质自然的一切不洁的污染。
And he can cut the knot of material existence which is there in the heart.
他能够把物质存在的这个存在砍成碎片。
That knot has been in the heart since time immemorial, since the beginning of time.
这个物质存在的这个结甚至从无可追 从这个创造开始的时候就存在，无可追忆的时间，它就已经存在在心中。
This knot represents a desire to dominate material nature by karma, by fruitive work.
这个结就是生物想要主宰物质自然的这个愿望，它被果报活动引起，是由果报活动引起。
And Narada Muni always glorifies Lord Ananta Dev.
Narada Muni 也总是在荣耀主Anandadeva的荣耀.
Narada Muni is the son of Brahma, and when he goes to his father's place, he will glorify Lord Ananta Dev.
Narada Muni 是主Brahma的儿子，当 Narada Muni 去他父亲那里的时候。
They will sing beautiful verses, which Narada Muni writes beautiful songs about Lord Ananta Dev. He will sing these songs.
Narada Muni 会写一些非常优美的歌曲，他用这些非常优美的歌曲荣耀主Ananta Dev.
And he has a person who travels with him, who plays at the stringed instrument. They have a special stringed instrument, which is known. Stringed instrument. The stringed instrument is called Tumbaru.
这个 Narada Muni 他总是在旅行的时候会，他去荣耀主Anandadeva的时候，他会带上的 Trimbu 的这个弦乐器。
Tumbaru. Tum. Tum. Tumbaru. Tumbaru is either the instrument or it's the name of a singer who travels with Narada Muni.
Tumbaru is also a singer, and he is also a singer. He and
So we're told all of these descriptions about Lord Ananta Dev, they're very real. It's not just some imagination.
我们这里描述的一切关于Anandadeva的描述都不是想象出来的，是真实存在的。But
we have to hear about these things from the bona fide spiritual teacher in disciplic succession, otherwise we'll never understand them.
但是我们必须从一位使徒传习中的一位真正的灵性导师那里去聆听这些荣耀，否则我们无法能正确的理解。
Right, this knowledge is given first to Narada Muni by Lord Brahma.
这门知识首先是由主Brahma传授给Narada.
And then Narada goes with his Tumbaru, with his friend, his companion Tumbaru. They travel all over the universe and they distribute the knowledge.
Narada Muni就带着他的乐器或者他的朋友 Tumbaru，他在整个宇宙旅行传播这门知识。
So the Supreme Lord is called Uttama Sloka, one who is praised by beautiful poetry. So Narada writes these beautiful poems to glorify Lord Ananta. We come from the same disciplic succession as Lord Brahma. So Lord Brahma, he's our original guru and our parampara. And Narada Muni is the son of Brahma, and he's the guru of Vyasadeva.
Narada Muni is the Brahma's son. Narada Muni is Vyasadeva's guru, Nixin Daoshi.
So Vyasadeva, he wrote the Srimad Bhagavatam.
Vyasadeva wrote the Srimad Bhagavatam.
So all the devotees in the Gaudiya, in our Sampradaya, we all accept the activities of Lord Anantadev as described here in Srimad Bhagavatam. And just by hearing about Lord Anantadev and becoming attracted by them, then we can go back home, back to Godhead. Right, because our heart is very contaminated by the mode of passion and the mode of ignorance. It's like a big pile of garbage there in the heart. And because of all this contamination in the heart, so that's why we have so much lust and so much greed. So it's very important that we get transcendental knowledge from the disciplic succession. This is how we can get rid of this contamination. This is how we can purify ourselves of this contamination. So just by the glance of Lord Ananta, or just by the glance of the Supreme Lord, the modes of nature cause universal creation, maintenance and destruction. Right? The Supreme Lord is unlimited and without beginning. He's one, but he comes in many forms. So in the Vedas it's described, when the Lord glances over the material energy, then the three modes become manifest and creation begins. Without the glance of the Lord, there cannot be creation, cannot be maintenance or destruction. But the Lord exists before the creation, and so He is eternal, is not changing. So even you may be a big scientist or a big philosopher, you won't be able to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So then Prabhupada quotes to us from the Chaitanya Bhagavat, and he describes Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, the four Kumaras, Vyasadeva, Sukadeva Goswami, Narada, they're all pure devotees. And they are all eternal servants of the Supreme Lord. And Lord Ananta is worshipped by all the uncontaminated devotees. All the people we mentioned, Lord Ananta is worshipped by all these pure devotees.
主 Ananda 都 永恒地被这些我们上述所提到的这些纯粹奉献者被他们所崇拜。
And Lord Ananta has thousands of hoods.
主 Ananda 有成千上万个头。
And he's the reservoir of all devotional service. He's the original person. And he's the mystic controller. But at the same time, he's a devotee, he's a Vaishnava, and he's a servant of the Supreme Lord. So there's no end to his, he's so great, you cannot find a limit to his glories. Nobody can understand him fully. So Vrindavan Das Thakur, he wrote this book, and he's a disciple of Lord Nityananda.
Vrindavan Das Thakur 写了这一本 Chaitanya Bhagavat 这本书，他是主力天兰达的门徒。
So he says, now hear how this Lord Ananta Dev exists in the lower planetary system of the universe.
他说,现在请您听这位自给自足的阿兰达Deva,他是如何存在于低等的星系中的。
So he says, Narada Muni always carries his instrument, the Tumbaru, on his shoulders, and he's always glorifying Lord Ananta.
这位Narada Muni总是扛着,带着他的乐器, Tumbaru, 他总是在荣耀着主Ananda。
And Narada Muni has got many wonderful songs and verses which he's composed to glorify the Lord.
Narada Muni 也撰写了很多优美的诗歌和诗节来荣耀主。
And just by the glance of Lord Ananta, the three modes of material nature interact.
只是被主Ananda的一瞥，物质自然三属性并相互交互作用。
And when they interact, that produces as the cause of creation, and then maintenance, and then annihilation. So Lord Ananta Dev is glorified, one without a second.
He's
the Supreme Truth without beginning. That's why he's called Ananta Dev. Ananta Dev means without limit, unlimited. His form is fully spiritual. And he only manifests it by his mercy. All the activities in this material world are conducted only in his form. He is very powerful and he always wants to please his devotees. So if we try to chant the glories of Lord Ananta, then it will purify our heart. So a devotee is very careful not to waste this opportunity. It's a very great opportunity to glorify Lord Ananta. So Lord Ananta is also called Shesha. Shesha also means the unlimited end.
Shesha, 无限的终极。
Because he can end our passage in the material world. He can take us out this material world. Just by chanting about his glories, everyone can be liberated. So the whole universe is on one, like one seed on the head of Anantadev. Although there are so many planets in each universe, and each planet has many mountains and oceans, but this one universe, each universe is on the head of Ananta. So he's very big, very powerful, because the whole universe is resting on his head, like a little drop of water. Lord Anantadev, he's not even conscious of where it is, because it's so insignificant, so small compared to him.
And
Lord Anantadev, he is chanting the glories of Krishna with each of his mouths. He has thousands of mouths, and each mouth is chanting the glories of Lord Krishna. And he's been chanting the glories of Lord Krishna since time immemorial. But he still didn't come to the end, to the glories of Lord Krishna. And to this very day, Lord Ananta chants the glories of Lord Chaitanya, and he has not been able to finish all the glories of Lord Chaitanya. So both the subtle and the gross matter, it's all existing within the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And the Supreme Personality of Godhead shows different forms to his devotees. He is very kind and he has all mystic power. And so that he will conquer the mind of the devotees. He wants to conquer the mind of the devotees and please them. So he appears in many different incarnations and shows many pastimes.
Right.
Just like Krishna appears, the Supreme Lord appears in many different incarnations as Lord Varaha, and that's for the pleasure of his devotees. So any person, if they're in distress or they're disturbed, if they chant the holy name of the Lord, after hearing it from a bona fide spiritual master, then they can be purified.
Right.
Even sometimes a person may chant jokingly, or he doesn't want to chant, but somehow he chants just by, you know, just by chance, not knowingly, still they get great benefit.
即便他是开玩笑的唱诵，或者他无意的唱诵，他根本不想唱，但是无意之间他唱诵了，他仍然会得到很大的益处。And
people who hear that person chant, they also get free from sinful reactions.
任何一个聆听到这些人唱诵的人，他也能够免于所有的罪恶。So
it's very important for us to take advantage to chant the names of Lord Shiva, Lord Shesha.
因此对我们来说，唱诵主Shesha的名字非常的重要。We
have to take shelter of the Lord.
我们应该托庇于主的，托庇于主。Because
He's unlimited, we cannot estimate His power.
因为主是非常无限的，所以我们很难估量他的力量。So
the entire universe is filled with great mountains and rivers, oceans. But the whole thing is just like a mustard seed on his head. Or it's like an atom, the universe is just like one tiny atom on his head. So there's no end to the glories of this powerful Lord Anantadev.
关于主Anantadeva是没有止境的。So
he is self-sufficient. He can support everything.
他主Anantadeva也是自给自足的，他支持着一切。And
his place of residence is beneath the lower planetary systems.
他居住在这些低等的星系之下。And
there he can sustain the entire universe. So Sukadeva Goswami tells Maharaj Parikshit that this is how I heard everything from my spiritual master. I am describing it to you.
Sukadeva Goswami, 现在说到，我已经从我的灵性导师那里听到的一切，我都已经给你描述了。
This world is created according to the desire of the conditioned souls.
这个物质世界创造是因为受条件限制的灵魂，他的愿望。These
conditioned souls always have material desires.
受条件限制的灵魂总是有物质愿望。So
they get different situations in different planets, different places in the universe.
根据他们的物质愿望不同，他们会在这个
This way they live in the material world. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written a song about this. He's praying to Krishna. He says, Krishna, I don't know when I began my material life.
他写道，我的主啊，我不知道何时我就开始了我的物质生活。But
I know I've fallen into the ocean of Maya.
但是我知道我肯定已经掉进了玛雅之中。I
can see that there's no other way to get out of it but to take shelter at your lotus feet.
要离开这个愚昧之羊，我没有别的办法，除了托庇于您的莲花足，我没有其他的方法。
Just like Lord Chaitanya prays in the Shikshastikam. Lord Chaitanya says, O son of Maharaj Nanda, I am your eternal servant, though I am so. Somehow or other, I've fallen in the ocean of birth and death. Please pick me up from this ocean of death and fix me as an atom at your lotus feet.
他说：“我亲爱的主啊，Nanda Maharaj之子，我是你永恒的仆人，但不知怎的，我堕落到这个物质之阳之中，愚昧的物质之阳中，请仁慈的把我从这个物质渴望净化中提起，拯救出来。
So Sukadeva Goswami said, I've told you about different, how different people get different, by their different desires, get different types of bodies in different planets.
Sukadeva Goswami 说, 我向您描述了人们是如何根据他们各自愿望的活动得到不同的躯体, 在不同的星球上居住的情况。
Whatever you inquired from me, I have explained to you according to what I heard from the authorities.
你无论询问了我什么, 我都已经向你解释了这一切, 而且这一切都是从我, 从权威那里聆听到的。
So what would you like me to speak about now?
您现在想要听一些什么呢? 我现在应该讲述一些什么呢?
So Maharaj Parikshit says to Sukadeva Goswami, he says, why are the living entities put into different material situations?
Maharaj Parikshit 就问道, 为什么这些生物会在不同的处境之中呢?
Can you, he asked Sukadeva Goswami, kindly explain this to me.
他跟 Sukadeva Goswami 说, 请仁慈地给我解释, 帮我解释一下。
So Vishwanath Chakravarti, he explains that different hellish planets within the universe are they're just slightly above the Garbhodak Ocean.
So Vishwanath Chakravarti 就说到, 在这个宇宙中的不同地域星球被固定在 Garbhodakshayi之洋稍微上面的一点点的地方。
Right, so that in the next chapter we're going to hear about how the sinful people go to the hellish planets.
在这一章我们就会, 在下面这一章我们将会描述这些罪恶的人是如何到达这些地狱星球。
And how they're punished by the assistance of Yamaraj.
而且他们是如何在, 如何在那里被Yamaraj的助手们所惩罚。
Different individuals with different bodies enjoy or suffer according to their past deeds.
拥有不同躯体特征的不同的人根据他们过往的不同的行为而遭受各种各样的反应。So
we'll hear that next week.
我们下一个星期将会聆听这一些。Okay,
any question?
Sati Madaji.
暂时还没有，我们稍等一下。
Hare Krishna, Gurudev.
Hare Krishna.
第一个问题来自于Shruti Rupa Devi Dasi. 顶拜Guru和老师们，我们在学习门徒课程的时候被教导，应该总是向最仁慈的Nityananda祈祷和忏悔，但是我在说话中更习惯直接向Guru和Krishna祈祷，请问这个习惯需要调整吗？ A basis to Gurudev. When I studied the disciple course, the teacher said we should always pray to the Lord Nityananda, and but in my talking habit, I just often pray to the Guru and the Krishna. So I want to ask, does this habit should be adjusted?
No, it's okay, because Lord Nityananda, he is the original Guru.
不用调整, 因为主尼天南达帕布, 他也是原始的Guru.
Just like today we're hearing about Lord Anantadeva or Lord Shesha, he is Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Shishama.
Shruti Rupa.
就是讲到这个主尼天南达帕布。
哦，主尼天南达啊。
可不可以就直？嗯。
嗯。 So I said, yes, she's thinking of Guru and Krishna. They're not different. There's no difference. You think of Guru and Krishna, you think of Lord Nityananda, you think of Lord Ananta Shesha. The same. Not a problem.
无论你是像 Guru, 像 Krishna 祈祷, 还是说像主 Nityananda Prabhu 祈祷, 还是像 Ananda Shesha 祈祷, 都是可以的, 他们都是可以的, 没有问题。
They're one but different.
他们是一个, 但是是有一点不同。
When you think of Guru, Guru is representative of Lord Nityananda. You offer prayers to him, it will go to Lord Nityananda.
当你向Guru祈祷, Guru又代表了Krishna,
代表Nityananda.
他也代表了Nityananda. 你向Guru祈祷, 这个也会到Nityananda那里。
Nityananda is not different from Balaram.
主Nityananda他和主Balaram是没有区别。Balaram's
the original Guru.
Balaram也是原初的Guru.
Of course, Lord Nityananda is very, very merciful.
当然主Nityananda非常非常的仁慈。
Okay.
Okay. Another? Next question also from Shruti Rupa. She asked, 另外一个问题请教Guru，现在很快就要过中国年了，虽然已经被家人接受为是素食者，但我还是没有能力影响家人吃素。请问Guru，如果我在参加吃肉的聚会之前，多多祈祷和念诵，而且只是带着服务的心态去照顾客人， 自己不吃不喝肉食者烹饪的食物，这样是否可以对聚会的人在灵性方面有一点点益处呢？ Next question I want to ask, because it's very close to Chinese New Year, and although I am a vegetarian and accepted by my family, but I don't have the influence to get them to be a vegetarian. So I want to ask, when I join these meetings, can I just pray and chanting and using a servant mood to take care of the other families and not eat meat by the, not eat anything by this food, not eating any food by these people. Is that mean, simple say is, she want to join this meeting, but not eat anything. When I join this meeting, can I have some beneficial gifts? Can these people they get some beneficial from me?
Can they get benefit from you? Well, if you're going to benefit them, how are you going to benefit them? Yeah, if you want to benefit them, you have to tell them about Krishna, or you have to chant the holy name, let them hear the holy name, or you have to give them prasadam.
你怎么样去对他们有益呢？你帮助他们是怎样帮对他们有益呢？帮助他们给予他们真正的益处是在于让他们聆听到圣名，让他们唱诵到圣名，或者你给他们派发prasadam。
You're not going to benefit them just by your association. You have to tell them about Krishna. You have to give them Krishna somehow.
你不是说跟他们联谊一下，你就给予他们受益了。你得告诉他们Krishna，你得让他们唱诵Krishna，通过某种方式，这样才行。
But if they're all drunk, if they're all intoxicated, it's not a good idea.
如果他们都只是在那里喝酒，而且喝得醉醺醺的，这不是一个很好的想法。So
be careful. Generally, we don't like to associate in these kind of situations, but of course you have responsibilities, you cannot avoid it.
要小心一点。通常情况下，我们不接受这样的一个处境。你应该小心一点。但是呢，你有你的职责，你无法避免这个职责的话，你得小心一点。
So you have to protect yourself. You have to pray to Krishna to protect you.
你得向 Krishna 祈祷，让 Krishna 来保护你。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from 小白 Mataji 顶拜咕噜，请问宇宙的底部的 Garbhodakshayi 王羊里面有没有生物？有的话是什么生物 ？Obeisance to Guru Dev. I want to ask. In the bottom of the universe, the ocean of the Garbhodakshayi ocean, is there any living entity there in the ocean? If have some living entities, what kind of living entities there?
Well, we're hearing the Lord Ananta Shesh. He resides at the bottom. He's laying on the Garbhodak ocean.
我们听到主 Ananta Shesha, 他就住在宇宙的这个底部，他就在这个 Garbhodakshayi 洋上。
No, wait, that's not right. That's,
okay, sorry.
That, it must be Garbhodakshayi Vishnu laying on the Garbhodak ocean, huh? Garbhodakshayi Vishnu lays on the Garbhodak ocean, and from his navel comes the lotus flower.
刚刚我要纠正一点，就是在 Garbhodakshayi 洋上面是主 Garbhodakshayi Vishnu, 而从 Garbhodakshayi Vishnu 的肚脐有一个莲花出来。
So this Garbhodak ocean came from the perspiration of Garbhodakshayi Vishnu's body.
这个 Garbhodakshayi 洋，这个海洋是来自于 Garbhodakshayi Vishnu 的躯体。
So I don't know of any living entities who live there in that water.
我不知道在这个海洋里面，在这个 Garbhodakshayi 海洋里面有没有什么生物。
But there could be, why not? Everywhere there are living entities, so there could also be living entities within the water.
可能会有，因为一切里面都有生物，在这个水的这个海洋里面也可能会有生物。
Yeah.
Next question.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from 大爱无疆顶拜咕噜，我是宝鸡的 Hari Puja， 想问咕噜一个问题。我的大姐以及二哥去年十月先后去世，因为我已经决定去印度，所以留给了他们骨灰，放在家里不知道有什么影响。现在又去不了印度，怎么处理这个骨灰？请咕噜明示。Obeisance to Guru, I'm Hari Puja in Baoji. I want to ask my old elder sister and my old brother, last year passed away. So I decided to go to India, went to India, and leave the
ashes.Yeah, ashes.
Give the ashes to them, but the ashes now is in the home. Does these ashes have some influence? Because I can't go to India. How to deal with these ashes?
No, the ashes won't have any influence. It's all right. Don't worry. They won't have any influence. But just be patient. After some time, the situation will change. There are many people in this position.There's many people waiting, they've got ashes, they want to come to put the ashes. So you just have to be patient, just wait for some time. After the situation gets better, then we will arrange for the ashes to be brought to India, to put in Ganga.
你不用担心这个骨灰会对你有什么影响，它不会有什么影响。你现在只需要耐心就可以。有很多人面临着这样的一个情况，他们的骨灰待在家里，因为现在的一个原因，我们都不能来。 但是你只需要耐心，等到一个确定的时候的时候，我们会安排骨灰来撒到恒河里面。
嗯。But you're chanting Hare Krishna, you're a devotee. Just keeping some ashes there, it's not going to do you any harm.
因为你是一个奉献者，你在唱诵着 Hare Krishna， 所以那里有骨灰不会对你有危害。
嗯哼。下一个问题。
嗯，下一个问题还没有看到。暂停吧，那行。
是我们现在没有更多的问题，但是。
哦，
有了。是新人的。
You know, I have a question here from Shamasaki.
Okay.
It's in my handphone. Maybe if I play it, you can hear it. If the spiritual master is not connecting you to Krishna, then you should give him up. You should leave him.
如果这个灵性导师没有把你和 Krishna 连接在一起来的话，你应该放弃这个 Krishna， 啊，不，应该放弃这个灵性导师，离开他。
That's the proper thing to do. So Bali Maharaj gave up his guru.
这是应该要做的事情。Bali Maharaj 就放弃了他的灵性导师。
His guru cursed him.
他的 guru 还诅咒他。
But that curse was a benediction.
但是那个诅咒却是一个祝福。
Because Lord Vamanadeva went with Bali Maharaj. He went to Bali Maharaj. Bali Maharaj lives in the subterranean heavenly planets. And Lord Vamanadeva went with him to live there.
因为这个巴利马哈拉吉去到的地下天堂星球中的一个地方，然后呢，主瓦曼拉德夫跟着巴利马哈拉吉一起去了那个地方，并在那个地方待着在。Next question.
Yes.
Next question from 新人 YY 新人，顶拜姑的莲花组顶拜翻译和主持。玛哈维什努呼出的无数金蛋都进入到玛哈塔塔瓦里吗？物质自然也在玛哈塔塔瓦里吗？无数金蛋。Obeisances to Guru's lotus feet. Mahavishnu breathes and many universes all enter into the Mahatattva. Are they?All into the Mahatattva, and the material nature also in the Mahatattva.
Yes.
是的。
It's all in the Mahatattva.
都在物质，都在 Mahatattva 里面。Next.
Yes.
Next from 陈真真。顶拜姑的莲花组，一切荣耀归于释迦牟尼。我看到空气、阳光、水构成物质躯体的八种元素，灵魂都是 Krishna 的 ，Krishna 也是我的 ，Krishna 也是我的主。那么其他所有人也都是 Krishna 的，对吗？那么其他所有人也都是 Krishna 对吗 ？Maya 也是 Krishna 的，那是不是所有的一切都在 Krishna 的掌握下活动？怎么样就是被 Maya 控制？怎么样就不被玛雅控制？Obeisances to Guru's lotus feet, all glory to Srila Prabhupada. I see the eight elements, the air, the sunshine, the water, the eight elements, and the soul, all from Krishna, all is owned by Krishna. Krishna is mine and my.Krishna is mine and Krishna is my Lord. So the first one is all the other people is also Krishna's.
All the other people are also Krishna's. Yes, we're all part and parcel of Krishna. We're tiny parts. Krishna is the supreme, and we're his part and parcels eternally.
是的，我们所有人都是 Krishna 的，我们都是 Krishna 永恒的一个微小的、不可缺少的一个部分。我们是非常微小的一部分。
Yeah, you read Bhagavad Gita, chapter 15, chapter 14.You can read Krishna describes here, all the living entities are eternally connected, they're eternally related to him.
我们可以读博伽梵歌第十四章第十五章，所有的一切都和 Krishna 有关。
Krishna is the father. Krishna is the father. And he's also the mother. We all come from him.
Krishna 是父亲也是母亲，我们都来自于他。
Yes.
The second part is the Maya is also Krishna's. So everything is controlled by the Krishna. Is that right?
Yes. The Maya is Krishna's energy.
Maya 是 Krishna 的能量。
And it's all controlled by Krishna. Maya moves under the control of Krishna.
Maya 是在 Krishna 的控制之下活动。
Krishna is the supreme controller above all others.
Krishna 是至尊的控制者，在所有的控制者之上的至尊控制者。
Mm-hmm.
And the third part is, how is everything controlled by Maya, and how to not controlled by the Maya?
Everything in the material world is controlled by Maya.
一切在物质世界的一切是在 Maya 的控制之下。
Right, Krishna puts the material world is Krishna's separated energy. It's not so dear to Krishna.
物质世界是主 Krishna 的分离的一个能量，对于 Krishna 来说不是那么的亲切。
It's all the conditioned souls are here in the material world.So we are in the realm of Maya.
所有的受条件限制的灵魂都在这个物质世界之中，我们是在 Maya 的控制。
And if we want to get free of Maya, we have to surrender to Krishna.
如果我们想摆脱 Maya 的控制的话，我们得臣服 Krishna.
We have to get free of the influence of passion and ignorance and come up to the level of goodness.
我们得摆脱激情和愚昧属性的影响，而来到善良属性的层面上。
Then from goodness, we have to go on to come to pure goodness.
从善良属性，然后再到达纯粹的善良属性。
嗯哼。
Next question.
Yes.
Okay. Next question from 沈阳的一个奉献者。顶拜咕噜翻译，请问祈祷时没有灵性名字，用网名和用实用名一样有效果吗 ？Hare Krishna. Obeisances to Guru. When I pray, but I don't have the spiritual name, I use the internet name and use the ID card name. Is that the same effect?
Yes. No problem.
是的，一样有效，没有问题。
Krishna knows the heart.
Krishna 在你的心里。
The spiritual names are for our benefit, not for Krishna's benefit. Krishna doesn't need the spiritual names. We need the spiritual names to help us get detached from the material body.
我们拥有一个灵性的名字是为了我们的好处，对于 Krishna 来说没有什么必要。我们而这个灵性的名字对于我们来说是有必要的。我们拥有这个灵性的名字是让我们不依附这个物质的躯体。
So we identify the name given by our mother and father, and it makes us attached to the body and the family relationships, material consciousness.
我们用父母给予我们的这个名字，我们就会有躯体化的概念，我们会有产生对家庭的这种依附，这是一种物质的知觉。
So the spiritual master gives a name to help us to change the consciousness that we can become more Krishna conscious.
灵性导师给予我们一个灵性的名字，会 改变我们的知觉，让我们更有 Krishna 知觉。
Remembering that we're servant of Krishna.
让我们记得我们是 Krishna 的仆人。
So don't worry. You can give yourself a spiritual name if you like.
你可以给你自己一个取一个灵性的名字，没有关系。
Hare Krishna.
嗯。
他这个问题是这样，那个苏比瑞派布，他是想问，因为他现在没有启迪嘛，没有灵性名字，就是说他现在是用自己的网名还是用自己的真实姓名？这两个有什么区别？就是假如说，有其他人，去帮助他祈祷，让他灵性进步啊什么的，就是说祈祷给他的这用他的什么名字有区别吗？就是说用他的网名给他祈祷，还是用他的真实姓名给他祈祷？这个会不会有区别？效果是不是一样？
I think it's the
same.
What's it? The one name is that when she goes online, she has a name, and the other name is.
Sati Mataji said, when the other devotees want to pray for this new bhakta, she asked whether use his her internet name or ID card name. These two names, are they the same effect?
Yeah, same effect.
是有效的，同样有效，一样的效果。No difference means.
Yeah, Krishna knows everybody.
是的 ，Krishna 知道所有的人，没有区别。Next question. Next question from Pushpasara Mataji.顶拜咕噜，顶拜翻译，请问咕噜 ，Krishna 一边要让我们成为他的奉献者，一边又派玛雅来阻碍我们爱 Krishna。Why? Basically, to Guru, I want to ask Guru, in the one side, Krishna want us to be his devotees, but the other side, Krishna ask Maya to not love Krishna.So why?
Krishna asked, what?
One side is Krishna want us to be his devotees, but the other side, Krishna arranged the Maya Devi to stop us to love Krishna.
Well, Krishna wants to make sure that our love is pure. You see, and if we get disturbed by Maya, it's because we're not very sincere in our wanting to love Krishna.
Krishna 想要确认我们的爱是纯粹的。如果我们的这个奉爱是被 Maya 阻碍的，这个不是纯粹的。
Maya is there to test us. How much do we want to love Krishna?
Maya 是来测试我们到底有多么爱 Krishna.
Are you just saying you want to love Krishna, but really you want to enjoy?
只是在说你爱着 Krishna， 实际上是你想要享受。
So Maya is there to stop the cheaters from getting in the spiritual world.
Maya 在那里就是阻挡那些欺骗者，阻挡他们回到灵性世界。
Yeah. We don't want any cheaters going in there disturbing Krishna's pastimes.
我们不想要任何的欺骗者回到灵性世界来骚扰、来打扰 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
So Maya is here.
Okay. 所以 Maya 就来到了这儿。Next question from Sugita Sangam Mataji. 顶拜 Guru， 感恩翻译和主持。请问 Guru， 既然灵魂离开躯体，躯体没用了，那躯体的骨灰撒到哪里，放到哪里，还有意义吗？很重要吗？ A basis to Guru, I want to ask, because the soul is away from the body, and the body is have no useful anymore, so the ashes put ashes to wherever put ashes, is there any meaningful for that ashes? And is there any importance for these ashes put to which place?
Yes, we put the ashes in the holy water of the Ganges, and in this way it takes away the soul, it takes away the sinful reactions from that soul, and that soul can be elevated in the future life.
是的，我们把骨灰放到，我们把骨灰撒到这个圣地的恒河，这样这个躯体的罪恶活动就可以减除，这样就可以提升这个灵魂。
If you read Srimad Bhagavatam, you can read about Mother Ganga, how she came down to the earth planet, and she came down to help. There were many sons of a king who had been burnt to ashes by their sinful action. So the water of the Ganges came down to free them from their sins.
So it's
beneficial for the future life.
这样对于一个人的下一生是有好处的。
Okay.
Next question. Yeah. Next question from 陈真真，顶拜 Guru Day， 顶拜翻译。Krishna 以超念的形式居于每个生物体的心中，那我们是不是做每一件事情都可以跟 Krishna 说一下，祈祷 Krishna 给我们正确的指导，告诉我们该怎么做 ？Obeisances to Guru Day。And Krishna use his spiritual super soul and the super soul form in every living entity's heart. So before we do everything, we can say something to the Lord Krishna and pray Krishna can give us the right instruction, tell us what we can do.
Yes, very good.
是的，非常好，这样做非常好。
But we can also approach the spiritual master and ask him.
我们同样也可以去找到一位灵性导师去问他，接近一位灵性导师去询问他。
The spiritual master is like the external manifestation of the super soul.
一位灵性导师是超灵的外在代表。
So just to make sure that you're getting the right answer from the heart, you can also ask your guru.
为了确认你在心里得到正确的指导或者答案，你可以去在你灵性导师那里得到确认，可以去询问你的灵性导师。
Yes.
Next question from Krishna Kumari Madhaji. 顶拜 Guru， 您讲到色欲来自于主。灵性的色欲和物质世界的色欲是不同的。我们在灵性世界的身份有可能是男人、女人，或者石头，或者草。那也就是说，灵性世界的个体之间的关系不只是有家庭关系的一种。那扭曲的倒影这种说法怎么理解？那是否可以说，我们在这个物质世界的婚姻关系都是以成熟的业报结果，灵魂只是根据业报扮演的各自的角色而已？如果业报结束，想休息精进的奉献者就不应该再结婚，而是应该专注灵性休息，完全依靠 Krishna， 对吗？ Obeisances to Guru. You mentioned that the last originally comes from the spiritual world, and the material last and the spiritual last is different. Our spiritual identifies may be the man or woman or the stone or the grass, is that ours in the spiritual world, each living entity, their relationship is not just the, is not only family relationship. This is the first question. Simple way said, in the spiritual world, the living entity, between the living entity, their relationship is not the only relationship in the family.
Well, the relationship is there with Krishna in the spiritual world.
在灵性世界，个体之间的关系都是跟 Krishna 的关系。
Krishna is there, and every living entity, of course, every living entity in the spiritual world is a pure devotee. They have pure love for Krishna, and they love Krishna in one of the different rasas.
所有的个体在灵性世界都是纯粹的奉献者，他们和 Krishna 都是有不同的关系。
So the thing is that in the spiritual world, you have Vaikuntha and you have also Goloka. So in Vaikuntha, the mood is, you know, servant, dasharas, but in Goloka, then there's more rasas.
在灵性世界有 Vaikuntha, 有 Goloka Vrindavan, 而在 Vaikuntha 大部分是 dasharas, 就是仆人的关系，而在 Goloka 有更多其他的关系。
So, living entities there in Goloka, in Vaikuntha, you know, they can also have families, they can also have their wife there, they can have relationship, they can have like relationships like that there in the spiritual world.
In the Goloka, yes, Guru.
In Vaikuntha as well.
Oh.在 Vaikuntha, Goloka, 在那里我们也可以有妻子，有这个家庭。
And in Goloka Vrindavan, there are many cowherd men and cowherd ladies, and they're all great devotees of Krishna.
在 Goloka Vrindavan, 那里很多牧牛郎、牧牛女，他们都是 Krishna 的伟大的奉献者。
And they can also have their wives there, they can have their family, but they're all great devotees of Krishna.
他们有他们的家，他们有他们的家庭，但是他们都是 Krishna 的伟大的奉献者。And the second part, she asked, how to explain the disjoint reflection?
How to explain what?Enjoy the reflection.
Destroy the reflection.
Oh, destroy the reflection.
Yeah, we say the material world is the destroyed reflection of the spiritual world.
Oh, perverted reflection. The perverted, perverted reflection of the spiritual world. Yeah, the material world is a perverted reflection of the spiritual world, because.The material world, it's nothing is pure.
我们说物质世界是灵性世界扭曲的倒影，因为物质世界的一切都不纯粹。
Just like we said in the spiritual world, there's pure love. They have the pure love, but here in the material world, it's not pure love.
我们说在灵性世界有纯粹的爱，但是在物质世界没有纯粹的爱。
So we don't have, because of our conditioning here in the material world, we cannot appreciate what is pure love. We are conditioned, we only think about sense gratification. We think love is all just sense gratification.
我们受到这个条件的限制，我们只能理解感官享乐。我们认为这个爱就是感官享乐。
But in the spiritual world, the love is pure.
但是在灵性世界，这个爱是很纯粹的。
And the love is directed to Krishna.
而且这个爱指向着 Krishna.
That everyone loves Krishna. They're not thinking.
所有的人都 爱着 Krishna.
They don't think about sense gratification, but they think about giving pleasure to Krishna.
他们完全没有想到感官享乐，他们只想给予 Krishna 快乐。
Mm-hmm.
The third part is that can we say that in this material world, our marriage relationship is just the fruit of the karma, and the soul is just according to the karma we play the role.
Yes, that's right.
这是对的。And the fourth part is, 如果业报结束，想要精进的奉行者。If the karma, if the fruit of the karma is ended, and the devotees which want to get some advancement should not get married, and just focus on the spiritual practice, or surrendering to the Krishna. Is that all right?
Yes. Good.
是的，非常好。She said, if the devotee want to get advancement, should not get married, and all focus on the spiritual practice.
Prabhupada also said women have to all get married. He said all you women have to get married. There were young women, and Prabhupada would say all you women should get married.
圣帕帕德同时也说所有的女性所有的年轻女性都应该结婚。
But then he would turn to the man and he said, all you men have to stay single.
然后圣帕帕德对着所有的男性就说你们所有的男性都应该保持单身。
And so everybody laughed.
所以所有的人当时就笑了起来。
But the idea is women, you know, women, they need protection. They need somebody, usually a man should be there to protect them.
理想的情况是女性是有人保护的，有人得到保护她们。
Without marriage, then women can be taken advantage of. They get exploited. They don't get treated very well.
如果没有婚姻的话，这个女性会被利用，而且会遭到很不好的待遇。
Of course, sometimes in marriage it's also like that. Sometimes women get married, they don't get treated, the husband doesn't take care of them.
当然，也有一些情况就是，即便这个女性结婚了，她在这个婚姻生活中，她的丈夫也没有很好的照顾她们，或者说对她们很好。
And so it's difficult. People get hurt, they get married, they have good intentions, they want to have a family, but they get hurt. And that's why so much divorce, broken families.
确实有这样的情况，有女性非常紧张，而且非常小心，她们结了婚，但是呢，又被受到伤害，然后所以有很多的离婚。
Of course, we have great acharyas who were also in family life. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was married. He had children, many children.
我们也有一些伟大的灵性导师 acharya， 他们也是处在家庭之中。比如说 Bhaktivinoda Thakur， 他处在家庭之中，而且有很多的孩子。
And Srila Prabhupada also was married, and he had 5 children.
圣帕帕德也是结婚的，他有5个孩子。
Of the Mahajans, if you look at the list of the Mahajans, many of them were also married men.
这些 Mahajan, 这些伟大的这个权威人士，他们大多数也是结婚的。
Of course, Lord Krishna had many wives.
当然 ，Krishna 也有很多的妻子。
Lord Shiva is married. Lord Brahma is married.
主 Shiva 也结婚。主 Brahma 也结婚。
Maharaj Janaka is a great Mahajan. He was a married man.
Maharaj Janaka, 他也是一个伟大的奉献者，他也结婚。
Narada Muni, of course, he didn't marry. Sukadeva Goswami, they didn't marry.
Narada Muni 没有结婚 ，Shukadeva Goswami 也没有结婚。
Anyway, marriage is only temporary. It's only a part of life. After marriage life, you have some children. Then there should be renunciation. Then you enter into the next ashram, which is retired ashram, vanaprastha.
当然，这个婚姻阶段只是人生中一小部分阶段而已。当你有了婚姻，然后再有了孩子之后，你就要准备进入到下一个阶段 vanaprastha 阶段。
Married life is not eternal. It's not like you can remain there forever. You have to move on from the married life into the next ashram.
婚姻生活不是永恒的，你得往前走，你得朝着下一个 ashram 前进。
嗯哼。
Hare Krishna, good day. Krishna Kumari Madaji 又接着问，他说那个如果出现优秀的人，是不是也是那个玛雅的能量啊？
啥意思？就是说他找到一个优秀的帕布，是不是也是玛雅的能量？
对，如果有一个优秀的帕布出现了，是不是玛雅的能量？
If a good
devotee,
yeah.
Yes, Maya will always test you.
是的，玛雅总是在考测试你。
It's not a good idea for women to get married again.
但是对于一个女士来说，再结婚不是很好的。
It's not good for their children, because you have children from the first marriage, and if they see their mother married to another man again, it gives the children gives a very unpleasant impression in the mind of their children.
因为这个对孩子是特别不好的。如果这个孩子看到他的母亲第二次结婚的话，又接受了另外一个男的的话，他会在心里留下一个很深刻的印象。
The purpose of marriage is to have children. You know, it's not that we should be thinking about getting married when we get older. In older age, we're meant to give up these things.
婚姻就意味着你要去考虑要孩子，结婚不是意味着你去思考两个人在一起老的事情，老的事情是我们要放弃这些婚姻。
If some man comes and he wants to get married, he's looking for a wife. We have many other single women who are not married and who've never been married and who can have children.
如果一个男士来了，他想结婚的话，我们有很多其他的没有结婚的女士，单身女士可以跟他结婚，而且又可以给他生孩子。
好的，感谢 Good Day。
Okay.
那我们的问题今天就回答完了。
回答完了，好。OK, Hare Krishna, Ganshya Sati Mataji Jujur, Ganshya Subhurira, Gewaman Fani, Ganshya Soya De Funkshanjar, Jufu Niman, Changsong Bin Kwaila, Wan Shi Rui, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki,
Chai,
Go back to Vrinda Ki.